Okay, there we go. There we go. There we go. Okay, guys, sorry about that. Guys, the pups are out for the first time now. They're out for the first time. I'm going to talk softly. I'm not even going to go around to the other side in case I disturb them. You can see it's just popping up. This is insanely exciting. I am in seventh heaven here now. If they've popped out like this now, they're not going to stop. They're going to keep on coming out. And I'm almost speechless here. This is incredible. Incredible. Oh my goodness. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Look at this. This is nuts. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Guys, this is what we've been waiting for 4 weeks now. In fact, over 4 weeks. I said, yeah, about 2 weeks I'll come out. And then just with these repeated cold snaps that we've been having, it just kept them underground. So there we go. First sighting of the baby meerkat. Oh my goodness. Yes. Yes, I'm just at a loss for words. This is just too awesome. Oh my goodness, eh? It's just one that we can see for now, but we can actually hear more downstairs. And you can see how alert that little one is. It's watching us. Obviously, we're totally new to it. This entire environment outside is new to it. So Veronique, who's actually with us here now, our meerkat habituator, when Jondra and I got you now, she said actually she had a little sighting of them late yesterday afternoon. And remember how cold it was yesterday? So their foraging was probably not as great as it could have been, and that would have just been actually forcing these animals to come out now to try actually start foraging earlier. So this is just so incredibly exciting that this is the first sighting of these pups now. But thank you for joining us on this. This is just so exciting. I'm just over the moon. It's suckling. Ah, how cute is that? That is insane, guys. Oh my goodness. This is just like all my Christmases come at once. With a couple added. So this is a precocious little one, this one, eh? Sure. If he's out and about and the others are still down below. Oh my goodness. Wow, wow, wow. Having a nice warm milkshake early in the morning. And I mean, you can see the size from the question. Yeah. Briska has asked, will the mom ever lie down when the youngsters are suckling like other animals? Absolutely, 100%, no question. And so I think this little one's just taking a chance while mom's standing up there. So, well, that's convenient. But I'm really hoping that the other little ones will pop out just now as well. But this one's obviously like, ooh, look at this whole big wide world. Mom, why didn't you tell me about this earlier? If I'd known, I would have been out a lot sooner. Wow, this is... And I know you can't hear it from our mics, unfortunately, but we can, like say, the sounds emanating from that burrow entrance are fantastic. There's a lot of like little chirping and growly sounds going on there. So yeah, the youngsters are very, very, very close by. This is just next level of cuteness, eh? And that leading on from that other question earlier in terms of would it fit into the palm of your hand, this is just giving you a really nice idea of the scale there when that little one's sitting right next to mom like it. I mean, that is tiny. If you cup your hands, that animal would fit in your hand like it, that little one. And you must know how vigilant these adults are now that these little pups are out and crawling, because they also can't move, as you can see. Look at that. They can't move nearly as fast as the adults. So if there was danger close to the burrows, that little one wouldn't be able to dart down quite as quickly as the adults would. So these babysitters and the alpha female there, they've got their work cut out for them in a big way now in terms of vigilance for the threat of predation.